Morning, guys and girls. Well, today is a big day, hopefully. Well, rain clouds stay away. Gonna be baling. I'll show you what we put on the baler. It was a busy day yesterday. Didn't get a chance to video it, but I'll let you know. See you in a bit.
I'll try to pull you. Just a little slower.
The hay a little tougher, not straw. We're baling straw today. Thank God. I want summer. I don't want to be baling straw yet. I'm just putting the pickup down. By the way, so yeah, it drops it down in there, and as the bale bales up the straw, it bales up that powder too. At least that's the theory. Sorry about the noise. So, in order to engage it, right now this is just temporary, but this little switch here, it controls a little motor on the back there. You can see a good look of it right here. So, that's it right there. Hi. We're going to be. So I like running my baler about 1650. Turn her on. The first time I've used this, so this is kind of all new to me. Turn that radio off. So, just still baling here. So first bale, I have to hop out there quick and check. It seems like everything's working. Oh. So the yellow light is on and not off. Like run about 1450 ton twine. You can see little twine wheels are turning. Everything seems to be working. I think we got an issue in the one spot there. Again. I'll check it when I get out. See, twine arm is coming back. Of course, the camera won't focus. And now I hit this lever right here. Out goes the bale. And now we shut it off. I grab eyeless down. Go with this little guy right here. So this guy here is a hay tester. So we'll go out here and check. Might not even need that. Yeah, see, I got an issue here. Cut him off. Oops, sorry guys. So this is a hay tester. Stick it in, find out what we're testing at. 18.5. Perfect. Bale seems hard enough too. 28. This side's usually the tough side. I don't know why on this baler. 18.3. 27.9. See, when I get something like that, then I just move a little farther up and see. See, 22, that's fine, because we're putting powder on. So, we'll do one on this side, see what we're testing at. 23, perfect. Let's go. Okay, so that's first bale. I'll do another one here. So, I'll let you guys go. I gotta do one fix on here. So, I moved on to my second field. Just tying my 12th bale on this field. And it's ready to go. There it goes out. It's a little drier on this field. Shift here, got rev. Ooh, that's a little high. Turn my little switch on. So it's a run a little high on RPM. Here. So it's a little drier on this field. A little bit drier. Not much. Pick this little chunk of hay up here. So for you that don't know, there's my cabin I built. How long ago? Well, it's about, this is a third year now. So yeah, there's my cabin. Running out picking up little pieces here. I'll probably bale this up. So yeah, there's my cabin. Threatening. I'm hoping they hold off for a while longer. So I got one more after this. Outside rounds on that where I showed you when I was raking single. so what do I have to tell you?
Okay, I want to talk to you about this monitor a little bit.
So this monitor, it's a fairly simple system.
Sort of a glare. Still got glare.
Oh. I should be watching my bale. Wow. Shit. And don't pop the clutch. Oops. That was my fault. I got my switch off. There's just too many things to do when you got your camera going. Okay, when you go. Nice. Switch back on. Come on, at level 4. So yeah, you want to keep your needles in the green at least. And fairly level, so your bale's going to be lopsided. Also, you got the lights up here. Green and red means it's the gate's latched. You're able to go. I got watch here. I got another bale coming. I want to turn it off when as soon as it hits 5, my powder. Now, now I'm not wasting it because on the outside of the bale, it doesn't matter. It gets there. Inside of the bale, which of course we get a bale right on top of the hill. I go down to about 45, 48 is fine. Make sure it's in neutral this time. But yeah, you see the needles aren't level right now. That doesn't necessarily mean too much because actually the twine right now is on this side. So it took the pressure off the needle, off the sensor out there. Where this side, it hasn't taken the pressure off. But it should have had a little bit more hay in there. And you seen that yellow light? Kick the bale out. The yellow light is supposed to flash when it's getting close to being full. It never does. I don't know why not. A little bit heavy stuff in here. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know why it doesn't want to flash. We looked at that. Dad figures there's maybe a wire on the one sensor out there that's buggered. But to find that damn wire, it'd take forever. And then you got this side, which is stopped. It's a red light. Yeah. It'll come on when your gink is not totally closed. Or, geez, I already got almost in our bale. Your gate's not almost, or your gate's not closed, or when your gate's not close being, or your gate's not closed, like latched, it'll come out or turn on. Usually, when you start making a bale, that's when the alarm that's saying, "Hey, your gate's open."
like, oh, thank you, now I gotta unroll the bale. But another time it comes on is when you got a oversized bale. So when the baler has a limit to it, to the size. So this baler right here, because it's not new and fancy like those new ones, it doesn't have a gauge on it. Your gauge is actually on the outside. Oh, and I see where that five is? A five is actually the mark for how big the bale is. So that, when it's like that, it, see there's the solid light. That means, solid light means it's tying right now. That's flashing, means it's, the bale is getting ready, but it doesn't want to flash. Like I said, it's a wire problem. What was I going to say? See, now it went out. Means the bale's wrapped, I can dump it. Yeah, you seen that red light there? That meant the gate was open. You do not want to see that red light. Trust me, I've unwrapped many, I unrolled many bales because of that. So as I talk, oh yeah, the gauge in the back there. See how it's moving? Watch the drive in here. See how it's much it's ready? So that's the bale inside the chamber there that's built or getting built right now from the straw. Or straw. From the hay. Ah. And all over the place. But so yeah, that's the size of the bale. It will never ever go beyond six. Six is the limit. So if you go beyond six, what's going to happen is that little red light there is going to turn on and this monitor will scream at you. And if you keep going, even though it's telling you that, what will happen is you'll bust the belts and probably pin a roller inside the baler. So you got some hay here. My raking job this morning was not very good. But I was in a hurry because of that. Still got little chunks over I gotta pick up, but I'll pick them up when I get back down at this end. Should go see now lights on. I gotta stop, idle down, let it tie. Okay, so on the baler when it's tying, you see those little white wheels turning? So that indicates that it's drawing the twine out of the ball of twine, which I'll show you when I get home. See, that side has a little wheel also. What happens is it goes into a little twine arm which is at the bottom. Can't see it right now. Oh yeah, now you can. See that little twine arm down there? Those two bars are moving. Those are twine arms. What happens is it dispenses the twine out so that it can wrap the bale. Ooh, that just shifted easy that time. Switch back on. So yeah, that's how it basically works.